Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In the waters of baptism, Paddy put on Christ and served with him and rose to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. We welcome you here this afternoon as we pay our last earthly tribute to a rather newcomer to our parish, but someone who has served a long and faithful and good life. We come in this Easter season with great joy, knowing that he is at peace and that we shall see him again. Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for you and our find new strength through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Siblings who, because of distance, could not make it here today. But I thank the many who have come to know Paddy, and I hear to honor his memory today, including the Knights of Columbus, that he was a faithful member since he came here 3 years ago and belonged to a similar order of knights in South Africa, where he lived most of his life. We are in the Easter octave, the 8 days after the great feast of Easter. And just before that, we know that Jesus went through giving us the Eucharist, dying on the cross, and then rose from the dead. And in that time, we relived the events of Jesus Christ. And today, we bring to fulfillment a life of over 80 years. And with joy, we commit him to the God who created him, who loved him, and who was always with him. We live by faith, not by sight, as St. Paul says. And he lived by faith. And in that faith, it brought him a certain peace and a certain joy. To come to this country after his wife had died, to live with his daughter, was a great transition, but he always exuded a joy about him. We know happiness has to be refueled. Someone tells us a funny story, and we laugh and we say, tell me another one. But he had a joy that radiated great peace that he was here, and with that, great thanksgiving of the care his daughter and son-in-law were providing for him in what would be the last years of his life. God called him rather quickly. He was here at KFC meetings, he was here at our monthly luncheon meetings. We have on the first Tuesday of each month. And I think it was providential, I sat beside him at the last meeting. And he very talkative, as he usually was, and went through where his children lived. One in Florida, a couple in South Africa, a couple in New Zealand. And I said to him, you could go on a world trip and be gone for ages. And he said, no more traveling. The only trip I want to make now is home to God. And I said to him, but I said, you're in good health right now. Little did we know that he was in a serious medical condition. But he never alluded to it. But all he did through that time we talked was show thankfulness for the people who he had met here, the people who had taken him out to lunch, and then even when Deacon and I went just recently to give him the sacrament of the sick and Holy Communion, he again spoke about the goodness and the kindness and how happy he was that he was here. And I said, it must have been a great transition. And he said, well, I lived through tough times in South Africa. We knew there was a lot of turmoil. We didn't know if there was going to be a revolution. And he said, I always try to stay close to God no matter what I did. And this is what he did. Stormy Sundays, he would come here to Mass, visit with people afterwards. Always that supreme joy of happy what he was doing. He believed that God would take care of him, and God did. Because in the final analysis, it is always, you know, what we want to hear. Well done, good and faithful servant. But through this turmoil in raising a large family, in difficult times, he always found time to be a member of the St. Vincent de Paul Society. And that has been in many places taken over by Catholic Charities or Catholic Appeal. But St. Vincent de Paul has always been a society following the French St. Vincent, who took care of the poor of Paris. And when he started doing it, he was criticized, and he told people, they're my brothers and sisters, their needs have to be taken care of. And Paddy did this with his wife for many years in South Africa. Whether they needed food, whether they needed clothing, he went and made sure that people were taken care of. And he said the same as Vincent de Paul, they are my brothers and sisters. And I think after he got here and came in and told me, and then he was presented with that medal that is on the table by his urn, he left South Africa before they could present it to him over there. But it was presented by the diocesan bishop in thanksgiving for all his years of service and kindness in the St. Vincent de Paul Society. So he fell right into doing good all his life. His sister, who was here at the time, said he always was kind to people. And I must say, I never saw him when he wasn't in a happy, kind mood. And this goes back, I believe, to his close relationship with God. Many times he said to me, when he was talking about a long plane trip over here, and I said, oh, I don't think I would want to be in a plane that long. And he said to me, you've got to trust the Lord. He said, I know it was a long trip. I said, do you think you'll ever go back? He said, no, I don't want to trip that long. I tested God once, I'm not going to test him again. He always had a jovialness about him and a kindness that we today celebrate as we, in this country, there will be another service in South Africa by other members of this family. But in this country, we are honoring him with Allah's final blessing and knowing that someone who is as good as he was had a large family and still found time to take care of the needs of the poor is doing what Jesus taught us to do. I chose the gospel today of the Last Judgment of St. Matthew. I was hungry and you fed me. I was out without clothes and you clothed me. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. These were the basics of St. Vincent de Paul Society. But you see how when Vincent started it in Paris, taking care of the very poor in the slums, how it has traveled. I've met people him from South Africa, I've met people from Ireland, I've met people from different parts of the world who were members are more at a time beneficiaries of the St. Vincent de Paul Society. So we look at these 82 years, all the things that he sent up, all done in love. And the love once given was received in the last days by his daughter and son-in-law. They brought him to their home. They brought in every exegetic to take care of a hospital bed and hospice, that he would have every avenue taken care of. And he was. And even then, when Deacon and I saw him just recently, he spoke about how good everyone was. Hospice people had just been there that day, and he said, they're doing everything for me. And I said, you deserve it. Because you were the person who did and gave your all for those who were in need sometime during your many years of service with the St. Vincent de Paul. I congratulate and thank Debbie and Dale for their kindness to him, for bringing him here, for giving him the love and the kindness that he had given. Love given is now love returned. And as we celebrate in this office of Easter, that God called him, not after long suffering, but a shock, that his suffering is over, and he now enters into eternal life to be there forever in the presence of Almighty God. God bless us all.
Light of Christ, scatter the darkness now, and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Paddy was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace. To all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Paddy seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel their darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Paddy. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We thank you, Heavenly Father, for the gifts you gave him that he shared so willingly throughout his life here on earth. We ask that he pray for us, and that one day we shall see him again, and we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray my sisters and brothers that your gifts and mine may be found acceptable by God Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all of his holy church.
Look favorably on our offering, O Lord, so that you, your departed servant Patrick, may be taken up in the glory of your Son. Father, who made us into your mercy, which is beyond all telling, into your love, which is a last good answer to the longing of our hearts, we commend the life of your servant Patrick, who has left us for a time, but not forever. We ask you to hear our prayer on his behalf as we speak in sorrow, but also in faith. Lord God, may he who used your gift of life to share with others now enter upon the more abundant life that Jesus promised. May he who bore witness to your love and faithfulness, your truth and goodness, now enter upon the reward that is promised the just one and share the victory of our brother Jesus Christ. Bring him, Lord, to the light that will never know darkness, to the joy that will never know pain, to the reunion that will never know separation, to the contentment that will never weary or cease to delight, the fullness and possession of all those good things which you request him in his life. We give any weakness which may be a sign of human frailty, and accept him as one of the joyous company redeemed by Jesus Christ. Admit him to the joy of which the Holy Spirit said, "Eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor has it entered the heart of man or woman to know the things the Father has prepared for those who love him." O Lord our God, may he who persevered in the faith now enter upon your kingdom. May your servant Patrick, who gave his life, labor, and love, be placed at the banquet where you are the bridegroom and we are the hosts. We give you in Christian faith and human sorrow the one you gave to us, the one we have been glad to know as son, brother, husband, father, grandfather, companion, and friend. We thank you for the gift of his life, and with your help we believe that his life continues and that we shall see him again. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and may perpetual light shine upon him. May his soul, the soul of all the faithful fathers and mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Immediately after this Mass, everyone is invited downstairs to the refreshments and to visit with the family.